Infinite IT Solution wants to automate their recruitment process. They have decided to accept 5 applicants for each of 3 job bands, A, B, and C, in the company. Write a Python program to implement the class diagram given below. So we have application dictionary is a static variable. Applicant ID count is also a static variable. Then applicant ID, applicant name, job band, all these are attribute of the class. Then we have generate applicant ID, apply for job. These are 2 methods we have. Then rest all getters. Focus on the business rules one by one. We need to initialize static variable applicant ID count to 1000. Applicant dictionary, it stores application count for each job band. So we'll have to create dictionary like A, B, C and having application count for each job. Generate applicant count, auto generate applicant ID starting from 1001 and initialize attribute applicant ID. Apply for job, which takes job band as a parameter. Accept the job band for which the applicant is applying. Check if application count for the applied job band has reached the maximum limit 5. If so, return -1. Else, increment application count for the applied job band by 1 in the dictionary. Generate applicant ID and initialize attribute job band with applied job band. For testing, create objects of applicant class. Invoke apply for job method on applicant object by passing the job band for which applicant is applying. If application is accepted, display applicant ID, name and job band, else display appropriate error message. Take a look at the code. So we have created application dictionary. We have assumed job band A has received 4 and B has received 3 and C has received 5. And starting applicant ID count 2000. Then we take applicant ID is currently none, which is need to be generated. And we are assigning applicant name alone. When we create object for applicant, we pass applicant name alone. Then job band is not set because that is they have given it as a task to set job band. So these are simply getters, and this is also getter, but this is get application dictionary. Is a application dictionary is a static variable dictionary. So we use applicant get applicant dictionary is a static method. Okay, then so look at this. We create an object for the applicant class and we are assigning it to A1 reference variable. Now we using A1 we call apply for job. So apply for job checks if applicant particular applicant job band count value is less than 5. If it is less than 5, it is considered. Let's visualize this. Now we create an object which takes an object instance is getting created. Look at this. 3 attributes, applicant ID, name and job band. Now we call this method apply for job. We check if applicant dot application dictionary of job band, nothing but job band is A, it checks the value job band of value and accessing its value key using key A is, if you say applicant dictionary of A, then it refers the value of the dictionary 4. So it checks applicant dictionary of A less than 5. Yes, it is less than 5, true. Then it is so, then what happens? It increments, it takes 1 application count, it accepts the application, so which means applicants count need to get incremented. So we increment this value and process for the generate application ID. Then what we do, if it is lesser than so, then what we do, we increment it. Look at this. We increment the applicant's value to 5. Then what we do, we generate ID. So generate ID, we need to starting from 1001. So that is why we increase the value of applicant ID count. Applicant ID count is a static variable. So we need to increment it. We are incrementing it. Then we are assigning it to applicant ID. Look at this. Applicant ID was none. Now it is assigned with 1001. Fine. Then application is set. Then job band is also job band, current job band. So that is being accepted. that is also stored. Look at this. Job and was none. Now that is assigned with A. It returns. Once it returns, it is not going to return minus 1. Then we are going to print applicant ID, then applicant name, then job band. These three details we are going to print. That's about it. So this passes all the test cases.